is it? Season 3, I think, like episode 6, man. Y'all know I like to be like the reality shows and all that with the episodes. And I know it's a lot of mad people. We had a presidential election, and Mr. Donald Trump, the orange man, won. So a lot of people are mad. Not only black people, but white people have been tearing up the streets of downtown Los Angeles and all over the world. So we're going to talk a little bit about the presidential election today. Also, if somebody could shut this door for me, that'd be nice. We're going to also talk about some great guests I have. I have, if you guys are familiar with Dr. Sabi, he has a grandson, Isaiah Bauman, will be in here definitely with us. He's actually a celebrity nutritionist and a trainer. He has a Dietary Resolutions and the Wild Living Foods, a new store that they just opened up yesterday. And also we have the man himself, Mr. Mike Boogie, a.k.a. Mr. Mike Malone. Y'all hear my nose? I know I sound funny. Mike Malone Collection. Some beautiful clothes. This brother is out in the streets, man, in the industry, like really going hard, working with some great other, you know, different type of designers, different type of people just in the industry. I went out the other night, man, and even met me an African man, y'all, on Wall Street. You know what I'm saying? So definitely networking with this brother, Mike Malone, is real big. I'm appreciating this brother. So shouts out to my sister, the kid, to Rebuild Your Life. We got a lot of things going on that we just built, you know, for the kids and all that. So to quit rambling, I want to play a video for y'all. And the first video I'm going to play to start off the show today, and then I'm going to come back. The number, right quick, 323-965-1600. Y'all give us a call if you want to say anything about the presidential election and how you feel. You want to talk to the guests. You want to talk to Bossy. Call us, 323-965-1600. And again, rmconair.com for my people that's watching me live on Facebook. rmconair.com is where y'all can tune in and actually see it live on Ustream. Of course, RMC On Air. The YouTube channel is where you can watch all the replays for Global Street Wave. And real quick, got to give a shout out before we go to this video to my sponsors, my faithful, good old faithful sponsors, Alka Shatter. This is the Alkaline Pure Water. We got today in the building, we have Albert will be taking the place of my man JG says. Today we're going to learn some Spanish, y'all. So let's give a hand clap and let's introduce Albert today. He's going to be up in here.
How you guys doing?
What's up,
doing?
Albert? This is awesome. My business partner with JG and Melanie. Melanie is props up to my MLM Media. So big shouts out to Melanie. And Albert is the man behind the Aqua Shatter and the Alkaline Water. So I got Albert in here today with me since JG's out. My man Supreme with the words from the wise, he's out and about working. So he should be up in here around about 8:30. And other than that, Al, what's going on? How you feeling, baby?
I'm feeling great, Bossy.
That's
overall,
right.
We're all just blessed.
That's right. You got some medicine for me? You see, I feel sick. I'm just you said we had a caller, the anonymous guys. I remember
yeah,
the anonymous.
He actually talked to me. I met him a couple weeks back, and you know, he was just telling me about the whole, you know, hey man, have you heard of Anonymous? Like, dude, I love Anonymous. And
wow, Anonymous, y'all, if y'all know who Anonymous is, that's those people that be on the internet gonna spook the mess out of you, and they be talking about all the stuff going on with the mask on their face.
V for Vendetta mask.
Yeah, so
if you
definitely.
Ever see them, it's they're here to. To say, you know, to make an impact on
and they
you know,
are,
people's
definitely.
Lives. So.
They are very powerful in their own way. Well, I want to give a quick shout out. I went out, shout out to Chef Milton, was on the show last week. We went out to an event the other night, and I was drinking on some Hungarian spirits. And this is the name of it, A-G-A-R-D-I. I don't want to misspell it, but... yeah, it was pretty tasty, man. There was some liquor that don't get you too drunk. Well, don't get you drunk at all. But I definitely had to mention this. It's just some Hungary Spears. Y'all can go check it out. A-G-A-R-D-I. And I got to give another announcement before we go to our video I mentioned. I have a sister, Miss Laquita Pittman. This is a cool sister I've been knowing, working with out the slave field. You know what I'm saying? But she's very business. She works in real estate besides enslaving. She works in real estate, and I wanted to definitely promote them today. She'll be giving us a call. And anybody need any type of help, think of buying or selling, call me. I can sell your home in the shortest time for maximum value. I will get top dollars for your home. Call now. Check out our sales in your neighborhood. Get a free market evaluation. Over 25 years experience working with buyers and sellers. Residential and investment properties. Jan J. Fritch is the realtor. She has her state license, TRG. Real Estate. You see that pic of the TRG Real Estate I got off the internet? Yeah, put that up there. The TRG, that's the Real Estate Group. And this is the flyer I was reading. So if anybody need any help with any type of real estate, definitely reach out to them. Let me see. Give them a call. You can reach my sister, Laquita Pittman, at 323-548-0025. That's 323-548-0025. And I know she mentioned they're in the South Bay area. So they do cover the South Bay area. And again, if anybody need any help with any homes, you know, Screaming Bossy not only here to act a fool and clown and spread the knowledge, but we're trying to help you, you know, get some property too. I need some. So definitely look out for them. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to take a quick break before we bring on our first guest, which is Mr. Mike Malone. He brought me a gift bag, so I'm waiting to see what he got. We can't get this wine bottle open, but we're going to see what I got in this gift bag. So we're going to go to this first video, y'all. I'm playing this video, dedication to Donald Trump, since he won the election. This is for everyone who was upset and at a roar when Hillary probably wasn't going to be no better. Why y'all all mad? Y'all know y'all history, huh? Okay, well, we'll talk about that when we get back. Let's go to this first video, y'all. Fuck Donald Trump by my nigga YG. Shouts out to all my Bompton niggas.
YG and Nipsey Hussle's video got shut down by cops for an anti-Trump song that's called Donald Trump.
I think we got kicked out because we're a group of black people, and like, I guess people, what's going on in America, they're afraid we're gonna say something or do something, but we just really want to watch the rally, and to get kicked out because we're a group of black people is really crazy. It shows you how racist our own school is. We can't even go to our own school.
Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah. I like white folks, but I don't like you. All the niggas in the hood wanna fight you. Surprise El Chapo ain't tried to snipe you. Surprise the Nation of Islam ain't tried to find you. Have a rally out LA, we gon' fuck it up. Home of the ride and the king ride, we don't give a fuck. Black students ejected from your rally, what? I'm ready to go right now, your racist ass did too much. I'm about to turn Black Panther. Don't let Donald Trump win, that nigga cancer. He too rich, he ain't got the answers. He can't make decisions for this country, he gon' crash us. No, we can't be a slave for him. He got me appreciating, nobody my way more. Hey, Donald, and everyone that follows, you gave us your reason to be president, but we hate you. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
I don't like your
yeah,
ass.
Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah,
I really
fuck
don't
Donald
like you,
Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah,
that's
fuck Donald
grandma.
Trump. Yeah.
Nigga, am I tripping? Let me know. I thought all that Donald Trump bullshit was a joke. Know what they say when rich niggas go broke? Look, Reagan sold coke, Obama sold hope. Donald Trump spent his trust fund money on the vote. I'm from a place where you probably can't go. Speaking for some people that you probably ain't know. It's pressure built up and it's probably gonna blow. And if we say go, then they probably gonna go. You vote Trump, then you probably on dope. And if you like me, then you probably ain't know. And if you been in jail, you could probably still vote. If we let this nigga win, we gon' probably feel broke. You build walls, we gon' probably dig holes. And if no ass do win, you gon' probably get smoked,
fuck
nigga.
Fuck Donald Trump.
Fuck you.
Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump.
Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall.
Yeah.
Mark my words.
Yeah. Hold up, I fuck with Mexicans, got a plug with Mexicans. When a little need a switch, who I call Mexican. This Comedy Central ass nigga come be the president. Hold up, Nip, tell the world how you fuck with Mexicans.
It wouldn't be the USA without Mexicans. And if it's time to team up, shit, let's begin. Black love, brown pride, and a sense again. White people feel the same as my next of kin. Let this nigga win, God bless the kids.
God bless the kids, this nigga wicked and weird. When me and Nip link, that's Bloods and Crips. When your LA rally, we gon' crash your shit. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
I was trying not to cuss on this show, but fuck Donald Trump, y'all. You know what I'm saying? We're going to talk about that later, though. I ain't even going to get caught up into that punk orange bastard. Hey, we had made a thing. My sister Nakia, right? She had got a picture. I think I should have put it up there, but it's okay. We got an orange rag for the gangbangers. You got the Crips, the Bloods, and you got the Hoovers. The Hoovers is everybody killer. And the Hoover gangbanging set wear orange colors. So we got an orange rag and put it on Donald Trump. It was like, Donald Trump is everybody killer. That nigga's from Hoover, because he's going to kill everybody. No, so anyways, I don't know who texted me, y'all, but we ain't going to worry about that at the moment. I want to give another quick announcement.
Charges over here.
I got to give a quick shout out again. Thanks to my sister Nakia. Also, thanks to the city of Los Angeles, y'all. I had to bring in my correct recognition because they had Global Street Wave and Screaming Bossy spelled all crazy. But yeah, the city of Los Angeles and the Council District 8 joins in recognition to the contributions of No Child Left Behind Stay in School Giveaway. Your commitment and dedication to uplift the community has helped make the city of Los Angeles a better place in which to live. So while I'm saying F Donald Trump, Screaming Bossy out here doing what she doing. You know what I'm saying? So thanks to the city recognizing Screaming Bossy and Global Streetway for what we doing, you know what I'm saying, for the community. And then we about to find out what this man, Mr. Mike Malone, is doing, because he about to be making Bossy and his wife some nice attire for these stages. You know what I'm saying? They're going to be like my Destiny's Child. Their mama made all them nice clothes. Y'all can see Bossy shaking it and rapping at the same time. All the singles, ladies, put your hands up. All right, y'all, let's give a head clap. Mike Malone up in the building. Mike Malone Collection. Shouts out to my man, Brian Supreme. Now, I don't like the camera, Kev. The camera is too close up on him. I think just give him a little space back if you can while we're interviewing him. And I thank y'all so much dearly for coming in, Mr. Malone. And what's this lovely lady next to your name?
This is Sandra B. This is my wife, Vice President of the Mike Malone Collection.
Awesome. And the Mike Malone Collection, you make clothes, of course.
Yes.
And we have some different pictures, of course, we'll be putting up on the camera. And you make women and men clothing or just women?
The men's shirt has just dropped today.
Awesome.
Show it so you guys can see it.
Okay, cool.
And
that's cool.
Today.
That's what I'm talking about. I like that. I like that logo. What inspired that logo with the wings?
Just a fist of fire I put together in thoughts of me. Like, fire means just like some anger that you have, and you put your wings together. And you
I
just,
like that.
You know, let God take it away.
I'm a fiery Leo, so that's why I got my red on.
Water sign.
So I know about
and
that
so
fire.
She a okay. Capricorn too, a dynamic dude.
Oh, y'all Capricorns?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I get along with y'all. Some my baby daddy Capricorn. He's a dickhead
over.
Capricorn. Okay, well, that's cool. That's what I'm talking about. Y'all like drinking? Capricorns like drinking and shit. Drunk.
Get mad and go sew some shit. Go sew a collection. Of
okay, that's
like.
Good. That's what I'm talking about. And speaking of the sewing, now this beautiful lady, your wife.
Yes.
As y'all see, we got a brother, and he think he's slick. He got him a Spanish lady sewer, huh? You want slick? No, I'm just playing.
Hola.
I had to be funny, y'all. Now, you have this beautiful young lady here. She sews all your clothes?
Yes. Well, she put the needle to the thread.
Okay.
At this point here, I've been instructed to sew.
Oh, wow.
I took over the needle and thread. And
oh, that's
we
super
have
cool.
Other sewers, but I put down the first pattern I cut.
That's
sewed.
Super
this is
cool.
Like Robin.
So you sewing and all that good stuff too. That is super
cool. I have
cool.
over 10,000 pieces.
So you a real designer.
I put my needle and thread down on some of that. But
that's
she set the tone.
That's super cool.
Of the
cool.
very basic of the collection, because the origin started with a look of like Rihanna-ish, but turned into, you know, something sexier than sexy. So
okay.
It collaborated with El Salvador.
Okay, and put some of them pictures up while you're talking, Ken.
And as well,
okay,
Harlem, New York. So it's a twist. And now L.A. up in there, so ain't nothing but love.
That's what I'm talking about. That's beautiful. And as far as the history, I know I was talking to her before we started the show a little while ago. She mentioned something about her mother. So just with her learning how to sew from the best, she mentioned, with your mom. Can you share some of that with us, what you were telling me earlier?
Well, actually, yes, I did learn that from my mom. And she's the one who, you know, teach me how to sew.
Okay.
And I'm blessed to say that. My mom is the master of the sewing machine.
And you said she worked on Crenshaw or something like that? I was in the hood. I'm
actually,
like,
actually, back in the 80s, yes, she did. She used to work, you know, in Crenshaw and Slauson.
Mm.
Yeah. And she's, you know, she got sick and she stopped to work there.
That's right. Yeah. So that's, now, did you teach you taught him how to sew? Oh, that's smart.
With the needle to
the thing. That's awesome.
I teach him how to sew.
But at this point here, I'm Gucci.
Yes. Okay, right? Uh-huh. So you can take over now, right?
I'm.
So you, what inspires? So you said Rihanna, the look, as far as you said, the kind of little Rihanna look?
Just sexy.
Origin of like an exoticness. I would say a Rihanna look because you know
she's
her
exotic.
With a Kim Kardashian.
Okay.
An open, free spirit dress with
ass. Yes, it is.
So a little skin, I should say.
Okay, there you go. I got you.
Sexy, you know, but grown, but we're into prints, strong looks, and, you know, just putting some fly looks on great ladies like yourself will do this evening.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about.
Yes,
now, you also been doing a lot of big shows, I know, as far as with fashion. You want to let the people know how to reach out to you as far as if they're trying to put together a show or if they need you for some shows?
Yes, ma'am.
Let the people know right quick. Even though you ain't about to get off air, we're still going to let them know.
Yes, ma'am. But on Knowing Wise, you can contact me at the Mike Malone Collection.
Okay.
At gmail.com. You could check us on a little Facebook thing. This is really a blessing. Social media, Mike Boogie 123 is Instagram. Mike Malone Collection as well on Facebook. We have so many damn Facebooks, but basically just reach out to me, 213-318-7538, and just say hello to your boy, and I'll put something together to you. ASBC, we got Hollywood on lockdown, man.
Yes.
We've been killing shows for the last week.
What's coming up? Tell us what shows you got coming up.
Shit. We have
is that a call?
Tiffany's on
Malone, before we get to the shows, let's take our caller. Let's get up. You know that may sound good when we live and we got callers.
Man.
So we're gonna cut you off. We're gonna get back to the shows in a minute. Global Street Wave, and we got Mr. Mike Malone Collection in the building. Thank you for calling. Caller, thank you for calling. Caller, talk. If I have all your peace, I'm hang up on you.
Is it still rolling?
What happened? Huh, Keita, where you at, Keita?
Charge it, because it's about, it maybe.
Okay, Keita not on, Kev. Did she accidentally hang up?
You want me to get the charge?
Keita, you got to put your phone off mute or something. Okay, well, she got to call back. Call back, Keita, because I can't say hello for 20 minutes.
Right.
So what do you have coming up, Mike? Call back, Keita.
December 2nd, we at Tiffany's.
Okay, I got that text today.
Shit. We're doing a model Monday coming up every Monday. I won't say the exclusive spot, but it will be in Hollywood somewhere.
Okay.
40 to 50 models coming out, strictly networking events where great people come together on a Monday night.
Awesome.
Just easy come together, some easy flowing group, great artists as well. Bossy will be the headliner for the show. Sorry to tell the world, but it's on and popping.
Yes, it is.
God is good. But, you know, we have a great chemistry of people.
Yes.
And I got to give some credit to my team as well, my wife, because without a team, you don't have a dream.
Yes, so, yes, yes.
God
yes.
overseeing all of that, man, is just like the chemistry put
so
together. It's just an amazing feature to see, which will be starting to be filmed, too. We do have a TV show coming out really soon. Mike
Well, I have acting credits, so you got to give me some of the acting, too. Boss, you've been acting. Shouts out to Rick Carr, 7th and Westlake.
Say again, ma'am?
I said I got some acting credit, too. Shouts out to 7th and Westlake, Rick Carr. I was giving a little props real quick.
Oh, but I want to give a big shout out to Miss Brown, your sister.
Yes, Nakia Brown. Thank you, Queen.
Nakia Brown in a building.
Rebuild your lab.
This beautiful thing together with this coordination of people and just chemistry and overseeing God is good because he'll put us together for a reason.
Yes, and we're doing something for the Christmas too, right? You with us on that, because you got the Christmas flyer for us. You got something,
yes.
You with us
the
on
toy
that Christmas
drive we have.
The toy drive, yes.
Yes, we have the toy drive. We're going to lock it in. I won't say name of the guest host, but it's somebody you see every day on TV when you wake up.
That's what I'm talking about, yes. We're going to have that. So anybody interested as far as in helping with as far as the toy drives go, definitely with Rebuild Your Laugh, Global Street Wave, Alka Shatter, and the Mike Malone Collection, reach out to us, GSWMGMT. At Gmail, as far as through me, and hey, we make everything and connected. City Council District 8, Marquise, definitely, I didn't say his name earlier. Salute to Mr. Marquise Harris, Dawson, and Albie, but they're definitely going to be on board with us again. As far as that goes, is there anything else? What exciting we have going on with the Mike Malone as far as some people that you've been working with? Have you been working with any type of celebrities at any events that have been wearing any of them?
The whole female cast from the show Family Times.
Oh, awesome.
Shout out to Kia.
Okay.
My good boy, Omar Gooden. I sized him up for a nice shirt, big bro. I'm going to get your suit going.
Salute, Omar.
Just that was the blessing put to the table last week, and we're working with them. So when you work with a group of people, she's got to do her thing, sizing and rising, and that's when the chemistry begins. But that's be our next project. We'll be working with the Family Ties cast, all women.
Definitely.
And with the Mike Malone Collection suits and ties coming out.
Okay.
Fire.
And I know I met a brother, was it from Iraq, a business partner of yours. So are you branching out, doing some international things as far as with the Mike Malone Collection?
Yes, we had come together with Rahm. He was supposed to be here tonight with me, but he couldn't make it.
Okay.
We'll be branching to Europe with the Mike Malone Collection.
Awesome.
Beginning next year, January. I tell him, let's start at my birthday. It would be a good vacation for me, my wife, and the whole team to go.
Cool.
Definitely like to snatch you to go up out to London and start.
Sounds like
a
deal. Hey, I'll get me a passport and we can go.
Yeah, shit. You got to get it right because you never know. We on the move right now.
Definitely.
And I'd like to give one great shout out to my boy, Solo the Chef, at Reggae tonight.
Okay.
He's serving the Jamaican food at Ivar and Hollywood Boulevard at The Study.
Oh, yeah, The Study.
Show, come on out. Check bro out. Taste some of that fire-ass food. Solo the Chef, Jamaican Cajun food.
That's the gentleman who was there last week when we were there? Okay, yeah.
We were a little turned up to eat, but we still had a great time.
Yes,
somebody ate some of that shit.
Yes, they did. Well, what we're going to do, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to go to one of Bossy tracks. We're going to play one of my tracks tonight, y'all. I have a track, On and On, my love track. Shout out to DJ Kit Kat, imported beats for this track. And we're going to come back with Mr. Mike Malone. We have my man Supreme in the building, so y'all can get y'all words from the wise tonight. Hey. But right now, Screaming Bossy, On and On, y'all don't go nowhere. We're about to talk about this presidential election. And Keita, call us back. 323-965-1600, y'all. I'm talking with a cough drop in my, under my tongue, in case y'all wondering why I'm looking like that. On and on and on. That's why my lovebirds going on and on.
You, and then I call you up, tell you to come through. You give me excuses about what you can't do. Cause you with the next chick trying to play fool, but you didn't know that my homegirl seen you. Then I get that call on my G2. Baby, your lies is all see-through. You about to get struck like a single. Because I'm on a mission for the stars, and the pain that I feel is ammunition in these bars. And you just on a mission for yourself.
And me,
I just break the hands that I was dealt with.
And you,
with your emotions, and I just say exactly how I feel.
Boss.
And you don't know how to swallow your pride.
Step it up, step
and
it
I'm
up.
About to step to the side.
On and on and on. We keep going back and forth, and we keep arguing.
So what you gonna do?
On and on and on. You accuse me of cheating, but I still call your friend.
So what you gonna do?
I was mad at you. Now you call me, and now you wanna tell me that you're sorry, and you miss me, and you want me, but you will say anything to charm me. So I really gotta know you mean it, and that you're thinking with your heart and not your penis. No matter what we go, do you know that you are the one that my dream is? And like Biggie, you just want one more chance, and I just really want romance. And we gon' have to go make plans. Fuck it, I guess it's one more dance, then let's get it then.
You just want one more chance,
and I just really want romance. And we gon' have to go make plans. Fuck it, I guess it's one more dance, so let's get it then.
On and on and on.
And on and on. That's my love song, y'all. Bossy be talking so much shit and cussing and all that. You feel me? We got to make relatable songs, artists. There's a lot going on in the world. We're going to get into the presidential election real quick in a minute. Just to, you know, kind of talk about that. And I'm going to see what Mike's opinion and what he feel about it. But before we go to that, let's learn a Spanish word from the day. Let's give a salute to my man, Albert. Albert coming in and standing in for my man, JG. So let's give a hand clap for Albert today.
How you guys doing?
What's up, baby? Albert, what Spanish word you got for us today to learn, man?
It's it's like a slang word. So it literally means be aware, but it's like a little saying. It says ponte trucha.
And okay.
The word trucha in a sense, just be aware of your surroundings, be aware of your people, be aware of the people that you let in, whether you're paying attention or not. Just yes. Always be aware. Just because, little backstory. The other, I don't know if it was a crazy like presidential election or not, but I was heading back from a friend's house and this guy was decided to follow me with his lights on, flickering on and off, and all kinds of crazy stuff from like, I don't know, for like 2 miles, dude, from there to the freeway all the way almost to my house. So, I mean, luckily, I mean, I wasn't going to let him get one up on me, but overall, it's just female, male, don't let this crazy world distract you from, you know what I mean, just from being aware and having to take care of what you need to take care of. So,
that's
siempre
right.
Ponte trucha.
Thank you, darling. We got a caller now, too. My girl, Quita, came back, right? Hey, Quita, you back? I said, Quita, Quita.
Hey, I'm here.
Hey, thank you, Queen. Thank you for calling, y'all. This is the young lady I was representing with the TRG. So, say what you want to say, Queen. Thank you for calling.
Okay, and thank you for having me. Hi, everyone. I'm Lakita Pittman. I assist realtor Jan Fitch in the real estate, who works for the real estate group. We specialize in luxury homes and properties in the beach cities like Manhattan Beach, Hermosa Beach, Redondo Beach, and all over the South Bay. Right now, we're in need of buyers and sellers. You can reach us at Lakita. This is the email address. LAQUITA1@gmail.com. Be sure to include your name, your address, your phone number, and let us know if you want to buy or sell, what area also that you were looking in, and the price range. Jen also has the highest end results, and we take great care of you. Also, Jan is a great realtor and an author of the book called Zone, Z-O-N-Z, at Amazon.com.
Okay.
We're looking forward to hearing from you soon. Don't forget, Lakita, L-A-Q-U-I-T-A, A1@gmail.com, and contact us. Looking forward to hearing from you guys soon.
Thank you so much. That's like an awesome commercial. That's my queen right there, y'all. Thank you, Queen, for calling in. I appreciate that.
Okay, thank you, Bossy, for having me.
No
bye
problem,
bye.
Honey. Bye-bye. We have another caller. Thank you, caller. Let us know what city you're calling from and your name.
Ange P.
Hi, Ange P. And where you calling from?
Las Vegas.
Okay, Las Vegas. And what would you like to say, love?
Nothing. I was shouting out my sis, Queen Bossy.
Okay, thank you, baby. I appreciate that. I got the hard cough drops, girl. I got like a... Been feeling kind of, the weather. I don't know what it is. It's hot 1 minute, cold the next. So it caught up with me. I appreciate the love. Anything else you would like to say?
No, that's it.
How you feel about the presidency? You happy with Donald Trump?
Not really, but, you know, we got to go with what we got.
There you go. So we've been going with what we've been getting anyway.
The Lord.
There you go, baby. Exactly. Well, thank you for calling in, Queen.
Okay.
All right, darling. Any more callers? Okay, that's right. Well, we're going to get back to our lovely guest, Mr. Malone. Now, did you bring me a gift, a little treat or something today? I love treats. I love when guests give me stuff. I feel special. Don't be jealous, Brian. You can't wear this girl stuff unless you're going to be dragging me. He's going to be my little drag. I'm going to play up with Brian. You got some money, Brian? You know how the men be paying for women to play him up and drag? I had some neighbors, right? And my son back in the days, he was like, Mama, it was this white man in here, and they was putting the wig on him and makeup. And I thought he was lying. So the homegirl talking to me one day, she was like, girl, we be getting paid, and we be putting makeup. We was putting makeup on this white man and this that. And I was like, oh my God. So that's what I was saying. I said, you have some money, right, so I can put some makeup on you. Did you get it now?
I get it now.
Trick?
Yeah.
Hey, trick, a trick. Trick. Okay. Ooh, sexy. Now this is smalls for my little booty, because y'all know I'm skinny and little. Look at this.
It's pretty.
Beautiful.
It's really nice.
I like this gold too.
You a queen, so we figure.
That's what I'm talking about. Oh, yes. And some cute little. Y'all know I look like a little kid. With some cute little.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep. Got the TPT.
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you, darling. See, Bossy always getting good treats. Let's give a hand clap for Bossy Treats. I feel like a little dog. You feel me? That's the Mike Malone collection in the building. Now, Mike, what else we need to let these people know? What else we need to let them know? I'm going to floss my other one again right quick, y'all, to go. Feel me? Give me some with that gold.
Microphone check. 1-2-1-2 back in the building.
Yes. Back. So what we need to let the people know as far as with Mike Malone, what have we not mentioned that's very important and vital to people? What was your inspiration behind the Mike Malone? What inspired you to start this collection?
This all transcended when I was working with a magazine. I got to give love and shout out to my sister, Yvonne.
Okay.
She had the magazine Designer Original. So with that, it's kind of been fashion embedded in me for years. But from working with different artists, from musicians to designers, photographers, models, you name it.
Okay.
And I just have been inspired to just get it in. And finally, my God dealt me that hand, like, now it's your turn.
Okay, that's right.
And, you know, when God gives you that deposition of a hand that you dealt with, you either have to ejected or deal with it, but you know, you got to step up the game plan and make it happen.
Exactly.
And, you know, and here we go.
And then we got the Mike Malone collection. So, are you guys going to ever work with, I'm sorry, you have to fix my fro. Are you going to ever do something for like kids? You know, maybe?
We are working.
Is there another phone call? Oh, okay. We got another phone. Finish going. Answer it. We are working what?
We are working forward toward February.
Okay.
Toward the Valentine's. We're going to get all the little mamas up their hearts. We got these little red dresses. We're going to put
together. See, so that's good. That was a good question then.
And it was a surprise question. We're going to try to figure out what can we get red for the little guys.
You know, okay.
Valentine's. Instead of inspiring the mothers, the joy that gives the mothers the joy is the kids. Really.
Exactly. Super cool. Yeah. Super cool. That's what I'm talking about. We got another caller. Hey. So caller, thank you for calling Global Street Wave. So, what's your name and city you're calling from?
Miss D Dangerous calling from South Central Los Angeles.
Hey,
but I'm in it right now. We're going down, Bossy baby.
Thank you, Queen. I've been thinking about you. Thank you so much for that lovely Facebook post. I appreciate that. She gave me some love the other day.
You know I gotta show you some love,
that.
Man. You
shout
know
out
this.
To Beastmaster Kendall. What's going on? What you want to say, Queen?
I'm not happy with Donald Trump. I'm not happy with Donald Trump at
but
all.
But what's the difference? We had all your mother white devils.
It was a betrayal of our country, big betrayal.
So you think Hillary would have been better?
Neither one of them was a great candidate.
Thank
they should have just left Obama in the chair. Real
well,
shit.
Well, Obama wasn't good either. He messed us up with a lot of sneak signs.
No, he wasn't good either. But at least it wouldn't have changed that much.
Like they're doing, like they doing now. Well, that was still a good answer, but I appreciate it. So
and also, I'd like to give a shout out to Mike Boogie. What's up, Mike Boogie? I'm still get in contact with you,
you
now.
You know, D Dangerous is
the mama thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm still down.
D Dangerous, so wear some of that sexy stuff. She stay looking fly on that stage.
We need you. We need you in our life. Definitely looking forward to bless you and style you to anything you spend it on.
That's right.
That's what I'm talking about.
And this sister here does music right here, y'all. So D Dangerous, give a shameless plug. Tell people where they can find you at.
Facebook, Miss D Dangerous, Google Plus, Miss D Dangerous, Spotify, Miss D Dangerous, Reverb Nation, iTunes.
Oh, damn. I forgot when I did it. I forgot when I did an article. I got to cut you off. I got to cut you off, D Dangerous.
Just dropped. I got it going down, y'all. New music coming
soon. Tell them your new single. Tell them the name, and I'm going to cut you. I'm going to say what I'm going to say.
Soulja. It's female MC anthem. It's all to all my female MCs putting it down on the MIC, ripping them on that old school joint.
That's right. That's right. Hey, I did an article for it. Oh, that's what you gave me props for, the article. And she gave all her social medias. It was like 50 social medias, D Dangerous. I was like, oh my Lord, just put at D Dangerous. D Dangerous got like 50 places she had. So just Google D Dangerous and you're going to find her on all her sites. You feel me? Right. Like, thank you so much, Queen. I appreciate you calling in.
For sure. We watching your show right now, too. Me and Beastmaster.
That's why I shared afterwards, because I need the views to go all the way up. Salute. That's why Isaiah is here now.
You already know.
All right, baby. Thank you so much. All right. Any more callers? Okay, cool. So what I didn't do, I want Isaiah's just now walking the building. We got to get him set down with us. So what I'm going to do is... Albert, switch seats. Let Isaiah sit over there with you, okay?
Gotcha,
so he can jump in. And we're going to just keep going. You feel me? I'm just improvising in the midst of it. I'm going to play a director, y'all, live. Because we got to make sure the last 20-something minutes, we get let him get to speak. We have the dietary resolution. He's a dietary nutritionist, in other words. Someone that can help us get healthy. You know, it's a lot of stuff going on with the air and the foods and all that stuff. But there's a lot of natural herbs and roots and different things that we can take. Intake into our bodies that'll definitely help us and heal us and cure us without us taking a lot of medicine. I might need something now with the way I'm feeling from the weather. But what I wanted to ask, B, you got a words from the wise?
Yep.
Okay, let's get to B's. Hand clap for B's word from the wise while we get Isaiah set up here. Go on, Brian. Thank you, baby.
All right. I'm Brian Williams with Words from the Wise. And my word for this week is focus. Don't let nothing get you down. Instead of thinking about bad things, divert your attention to good things in your life. Focus on your goals and what you can do to achieve them. Focus on love, not hate. Focus on working hard to achieve your dreams. Focus on positivity, not negativity. Focus on uplifting others so that you will be uplifted. Focus on being a role model for kids because they are our future.
Yes.
Focus on doing the right thing and making the right decisions in your life.
Yes.
Focus on inner peace within yourself and let go of all negativity to achieve positive energy. Focus on all your achievements in life to bring yourself confidence and determination. Focus on loving yourself and make every day count. Enjoy life to the fullest. I'm Bryant Williams, a.k.a. Supreme, with Words from the Wise.
That's right. I like that focus because Albert came with the word, which was to stay aware, right?
Right.
And be aware and alert. And then you said focus. So it all goes together. In English, focus, y'all. In Espanol, is what Albert said. Rewind it, showing you'll get it again because I forgot it already. Now we have Isaiah. Mr. Dr. Sabi, you guys. Very, very, very special light to the world that transcended to another place, another realm. Not hear a word about Donald Trump like everybody else is. But his grandson, you know, is definitely living a beautiful legacy of him because of the simple fact with the healthiness and our wholeness of just our bodies and things that we can do besides eat McDonald's and Jack in the Box and all this fast food y'all running y'all kids to because you're too lazy to cook.
Okay.
So we're going to let him definitely speak to us about some things that he has going on for our last little bit of the show while we got a chance. And we're going to close out with Mr. Malone. So let's give a hand clap now for our brother Isaiah Bauman. Am I saying it right? I'm saying it right, Isaiah, baby. Yes, thank you so much for coming up in here. Now, I know you got a lot going on because I know you into the nutritionist and I see you with a ball in your hand. So I know you got two things I want to mention, talk about. But first off, let people know who you are. Let me let you tell people who you are, darling.
My name is Isaiah Bauman and I am Dr. Sabi's first grandson.
And sit up. Sit your butt up, boy. There you go. Sit your butt up.
Yeah.
There you go.
Come on, get there.
You had to say it nice and make you laugh. Sit your ass up. Okay, now there you go.
Perfect. So I am Dr. Sabi's first grandson, and I am a nutritionist, and I am truly sorry I'm late.
No, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Keep going. We got some time.
Health and different people's illness in due course. Me to be late sometime.
That's right. That's right.
When you save your lives, you know that's very important.
That's right.
I am a nutritionist. I work for Dietary Resolutions. And we have the number one products in the world.
Yes.
Ours with healing. Our community has to get healthy. That is the movement right now, especially with Trump being in office. We have to keep our bodies alkaline.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. As far as eating the proper fruits, the proper vegetables, drinking the proper water, taking the proper supplements.
Yes.
You know, our community suffer from high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, yes, cancer. You know, all of us can relate to someone in their family having cancer.
Yes.
And it's all from the food that we eat. It's a program. Mm-hmm. Yes. It's by design as well. 80% of the food that we eat is processed. And what my grandfather was trying to teach the world and the community is that it's the easy way of eating if you eat the proper fruits and vegetables to alkaline the body.
Yes.
Such as kale, spring mix salad, broccoli. We just cut that out of our program.
Yeah,
that's the last thing we talked about before he passed.
Oh, wow.
Was broccoli and almonds and cauliflower and how corn is, you know, genetically modified, you know, in a laboratory. And our community has to wake up as well. As far as we're eating healthier food and making healthier choices, because we are the future. And if we don't stay healthy, we're going to die off. It's population control.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, and that it is.
So right now we have a 7-day challenge, but we're encouraging everybody in our community to take this challenge. Fast for 7 days, and that's eating salad, water, and fruit.
Okay.
And people say, what water? Crystal Geyser water, Fiji water is the top waters in the country.
Yeah, I was right. Okay. Crystal Geyser. I was trying to think of that. Yeah. Because I've seen it on YouTube. I guess that was a lie.
No, that wasn't a lie. That's one of the top waters in the country. Hmm. And we definitely encourage that water. Fiji water as well. Well, people say alkaline water. That's a fad. The only people that should be drinking alkaline water is people that have cancer. If you just drinking alkaline water for your everyday use, then you doing harm to your body as well.
That's true?
That's definitely
no,
true.
No, come on, educators, because I got alkaline water. I'm over here sipping. I smoke cigarettes, so I ain't going to lie, man. Only thing.
Okay, well,
I'm trying to combat the cancer. No, I'm just being real.
Alkaline water will make your body deficient, give you gallstones, kidney stones, and it'll destroy the pH in your body.
So
if you, that's only good for people who have cancer and going through stage 4 radiation treatment.
So it is good to drink alkaline water if you do have cancer,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, if you have cancer, that's excellent. Because, see, what happens is that... What happens is that when you're going through radiation treatment, your body depletes all the electrolytes from the radiation. It strips the body from its natural nutrients.
Yes.
So that water, that alkaline water, will put some electrolytes into the body. But drinking it on an everyday basis will do harm to the body.
So Crystal Geyser and Fiji water is good.
Oh, that's excellent.
Okay, well, I know a lot of preachers, when I used to go to church, they always got Fiji water.
Oh, yeah, that's the best water.
Yeah.
Okay, now, not to go off subject, but I know we got a little bit of time. You mentioned about a store you guys just opened up.
Yes, we did open a restaurant called Wild Living Foods.
Okay, I'm sorry, say it again, because I know I was talking.
Yes, it's our restaurant just opened up Friday. We had our grand opening called Wild Living Foods, and I encourage anybody that's into eating healthy, eating raw foods, trying to become vegan or is a vegan, you know, I definitely encourage you check out Wild Living Foods off of Main and 8th. It will be very beneficial for you. We have juices, all natural. We have all natural salads. You can create it your way. And we definitely going to be teaching our community how to eat healthy as well.
Okay, I'm sorry, I'm over your sidebarring. I took pictures off of your site. Now, hold on, is this some stuff from your stuff that I done took off the internet?
Yes.
That ice cream, that look all good and like...
That's our all-natural gelato. You can, and that's dairy-free as well.
Okay. Yeah, I'm over here. I'm undercover, and while you're talking, I'm like, put the pictures up. And then you flick to another one, Kev. What is that right there? Like a little drink.
Yes, that's our all-natural juices, and I am drinking one right here in my hand.
What should I drink with this funny way I sound? Like Miss Piggy.
You said, what's
good for what I got right now going on? I don't know what this is. You know,
I hear a lot of inflammation in your voice right now. Do you eat a lot of cheese?
Not really, but I just ate some cheese the other night at an event I went to, some brie cheese.
Yeah. Mm. And see, that causes mucus.
It's funny you said that.
Do you drink coffee?
Oh, too. Yes, I do. I don't even like you being here. I feel like I'm talking to the priest. I feel like a Christian all over again.
Well, see, that coffee is very harmful, especially for our community, because we wake up and think coffee is healthy, and it's really not.
No, I don't even think it's healthy. It's just addictive, like crack is to crack is. I just like the taste and the smell.
The taste.
That's all. It ain't even about no healthy.
Right. And
I thought it wasn't healthy. Shoot.
Right. And see, by drinking coffee, that causes inflammation.
Okay.
That stains the teeth. That causes high cholesterol.
Yes, it does.
And for you, that'll give you breast cancer, because that's the number one thing linked to breast cancer.
I ain't never heard that one. Wow. I like you being here. Okay.
So, yeah, please stop drinking coffee.
Oh, y'all, we got to stop drinking coffee in the morning, posting on Facebook. We got up and we drinking our coffee.
Yeah, right? We running to Starbucks and it's killing us.
Wow. Well, we already know that. Look at the symbol. That's another story.
High blood pressure, high cholesterol is created all from Starbucks.
Exactly.
Because you're drinking coffee every day.
Okay.
365 days in a year, most Americans are drinking coffee.
Yes.
Eating eggs, eating cheese. Eating bacon, eating toast.
So what's a good supplement for that energy with all this good whole stuff?
What's a good supplement? I tell people to drink all natural teas, such as chamomile, raspberry tea.
Okay.
It's really good. You can't drink a green tea as long as it don't have caffeine. Those are really good as well.
Okay.
Yeah, I want to definitely get you something for that cough.
Yeah, you see, I just came out in the last like couple of days.
Yeah,
I've been having it.
We have an all-natural supplement as well called CMOS.
Because I know this cough drop ain't going to do nothing that I'm supposed to. What's bad about this? I'm going to get cancer sucking on this?
No, you're not going to get cancer sucking on that. But it's not. It's a suppressant.
That's what I'm knowing. I just took it because it's making, and it's all mental. You feeling like the stuff helped. We have another caller. We have a caller. Huh?
Isha.
Okay, yeah, I wasn't gonna stop this little old nasty cough from me doing my show. We got the health. We got the health man here. I'm here to get help. Yeah. And shame the devil. Thank you for calling Global Streetwave. Screaming bossy coughing in your ear. Tell us your name and what city you calling from.
Hey, this is Isha. I'm calling from Los Angeles.
Hey, Isha.
Hey, bossy.
What's up, baby? How you doing?
I'm doing good. This is my first time calling in. I know it's been a while, but I'm just touching bases with you guys. I just want to say you guys are doing an awesome job.
Thank you, darling. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
And you're looking good, bossy. You're
Thank
looking
you,
better
baby.
And better.
Are you
every
from,
10 days.
Are you okay? Are you from, well, I need to stop drinking coffee and stuff. I'll be all right. Are you familiar with Dr. Sabi Queen? Dr. Sabi?
No, not really, but I've been checking the show out today, and I've just been, you know, just kind of tuning in a little bit.
Well, what I want you to do for me is take a break from Facebook, Instagram, and all them other little stupid social media distractions.
Okay.
And I want you to go on YouTube, because you can go watch him, and it won't be a lie. Go look up Dr. Sabi, you and your son, and go get some knowledge on that man. A lot of different things about the health and all that good stuff.
You said Dr. Sabi?
S-A-B-I.
Sabi.
Yep, and also look up this gentleman here on the show. But Dr. Sabi, that gentleman right here on the screen, you definitely need to go check him out. It's a lot of information out here. And thank you for calling.
Thank you for having me on the show.
All right, baby. Yeah.
Mike, you have a good one.
You too, honey.
Mike,
all right, baby. Mike, you should have brought me a watch, too. Your watch over there glycerin. Like ice. Okay, now, Isaiah, so how much more minutes we got, Kev? So, Isaiah, now back to you. I want to mention this right quick, because I know we can go all day with the health. You can come back here 50,000 times and make me feel condemned and convicted.
Definitely.
I think I ain't going to invite you back to next year. Now, listen to this. Ball. I send you with a ball in your hand that I used on a flyer. You do something with the basketball or anything? You play ball?
Yes, I did play basketball. I won a tournament called the Red Bull King of the Rock.
Sit your butt up again.
Sit.
Okay, there you go. Your grandpa didn't teach you to do that. That's bad posture. Now I got to get her back.
Yeah.
Make me feel bad about drinking coffee. That's bad posture. You know that, bro.
Right.
I'll just let go to go.
I do play basketball, and I won a basketball tournament called the Red Bull King of the Rock.
Oh, wow.
And I play 64 people one-on-one in basketball on Alcatraz.
Oh, wow.
And I went down in the Guinness Book of Records as well.
Oh, you're the ball like your granddaddy.
Yeah.
And let the viewers know a little quick history on Dr. Sabi right quick. We mentioned him. Like, you know how the rappers be like, I did a song with such and such.
Right.
Well, this is Dr. Sabi's grandson, and this man is more beneficial than any rapper or anybody you're going to ever do anything with.
Right.
Because this man is definitely life-saving. And he gonna have me. I'm already trying to quit my one habit. And then he gonna have me. I ain't worried about coffee, though. I can drink some tea. Okay. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sidebarring myself, trying to convict myself. Let these people know a little bit about Dr. Sabi.
Dr. Sabi was an incredible man. He showed people that not only there's a cure for every disease in America, but you can do anything because life is about taking chances. And he took that chance and went against the grain and came to America as a foreign man coming from Honduras. Wow. And in that time, you know, it was still racism. There was still different cultures couldn't even come to America and okay. get a job. So my grandpa came here and tapped into something that was incredible, such as healing.
That's right. Yes.
And when he went to the Supreme Court justice in the 70s and said, I have a cure for AIDS, cancer, and diabetes and lupus, they locked him up, you know, took him to jail and was going to give him life because who are you to say that you have a cure for this disease, never been to school, don't have a college degree, but you cure AIDS and cancer, and you're a foreigner from another country.
Right.
But you look black as well.
Huh.
And you speak Spanish, so who do you think you are?
Okay.
Wow. Right. So they had to lock him up. And then they told him he was lying. So he went to court. He didn't want any representation, a fake public defender.
Okay.
You know, the lawyer, because he felt like everybody was against him, which they was. It was like, you lying. You about to go to jail for life. You know, even some of the family said, what are you doing? You going to jail. Look what you said. Look what you did. He said, I'm not going to jail. I have a cure.
Wow.
The judge told him to come with 10 to 12 people of each disease. We came with 120 people of each disease.
Oh, wow.
So they had to grant him his cure that's FDA approved and AMA approved.
Awesome.
We're the only herbal company in the world that's FDA approved and AMA approved.
So that's good.
By the FDA.
Really good.
Yeah, and GMC not even FDA approved.
Okay.
Wow. You can look that up. And people take that every day and think they're getting minerals and supplements from
That's right.
Right.
So let us know again where we can find you at, man. Let us know again. When you say you just opened up the store, Wild Living Foods.
Yes.
So people can actually go and get this. Tell them again.
You can find us at Wild Living Foods off of Main and 8th.
Okay.
You can follow me at Dietary Resolutions. And we will get you healthy.
Okay.
It's about saving our community.
Yes.
Everybody needs CMOS.
Yes.
Our community needs CMOS because CMOS has 92 of 102 minerals what the body is composed of.
Wow.
So that's high in zinc. Ooh. That's high in calcium. That enriches the blood. That tones the body naturally. That get rid of thyroids, fibroids. Anyone who has arthritis pain, joint pain.
Oh, wow.
It's excellent for the skin. It improves the hair growth and the nail growth at the same time.
That's awesome.
That's a lot.
Wow. So everybody needs that. If you have high blood pressure or high cholesterol, you need CMOS.
If more colored folk would pay attention to you guys instead of Facebook and ranting so much and go find some medicine, because people get sugar, be all the stuff we eating, and then we... It's like, this is like condom before sex. You can go buy a condom, right?
Right.
But they need to go get y'all.
We need to start
paying attention to this healthy stuff.
Yes,
I'm serious.
Health as well. Should we pay attention to fashion and cars and, you know, the material things in life. And now we have to start paying attention to our health.
We got to be healthy while we're looking good. That's why we got the fashion.
Yeah, we got
to look. We got long hair, fashion meets health. And I don't know if I'm going to be able to... I'm gonna just be pretty and buy
that.
Now listen, I want to ask another quick question. I mentioned in the beginning, you are a nutritionist trainer too. Now, besides the store, I see you with some celebrities on Pixar. Are you training celebrities or something?
I do deal with a lot of celebrities. I meal prep. I train them.
Okay.
You know, I train a lot of celebrities such as Martavius Bryant, Lil Boosie, 80 Hip Hop is what needs CMOS. You know, if you're an athlete, if you're in the NFL, NBA, or in hip-hop, or in fashion, you need to get healthy because that's what's important. You know, a lot of people in hip-hop, they fall out on stages, they're malnourished.
Yeah, they're drinking too much syrup. Yeah.
Right.
Alcohol, poison.
That's real.
You know, people in fashion, they always on the road, you know.
Not eating.
Poor eating habits, lack of eating, you know, dehydration. So, you know, I make sure that our people are healthy on an everyday basis.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That is awesome. That is super awesome. So we got to somehow tie in those models. You know, Nakia over here on the sideline, I'm going to bust her out. Salute again to my sister Nakia. She's trying to sell his tea over here. We got him up in here. We need to get these models on some of this nutritionist stuff with Isaiah, and then Bossy going to have to be included. If I think I'm going to be on the stage rapping. I still look young.
I see the vision.
Do you guys have something for teeth? I went to the dentist the other day, man. They were trying to show me all this money to keep these back teeth, boy. I'm telling the truth, y'all. Is there something that we can take to help our teeth be strong? Because, you know, the coffee, like you said, smoking, that stuff, you know.
I definitely encourage people to brush with coconut oil.
Okay.
Definitely.
So I need to get some coconut oil. That'll help make the teeth stronger?
That'll make the teeth stronger and whiter as well.
Oh, that's good.
Okay.
And get you some kale, because that'll definitely build the immune system and put the fiber in the body and put calcium back into the body. That's what strengthens teeth as well.
Okay, super cool. See, I'm trying to get some help, self-help, feel free, quick help, free consultation, y'all. So y'all, I hope y'all paying attention today, y'all. Global Streetway, Bossy here to help you look good with Mr. Malone, and I'm here to help you get your body in shape so you can look good with Mr. Malone with Isaiah. So it all goes together, y'all. We can think we fly, you know, I'm almost 100, looking like I'm 22 still, you know what I'm saying? But hey, if I don't take care of myself, I can quickly start looking like I'm 80 in the next 3 months.
Okay.
So we're not going nowhere yet. Before we get out of here, we got like probably about a few more minutes. I want to let us end off right quick. Isaiah, and first I'll ask Isaiah, then I'll ask you quickly, what do you guys feel about our new wonderful orange man, the president? And of course, I'm not expecting you to make a long, you know.
I just feel like it's time for our community to come together as people.
Yes.
No more color lines. No more, you know, calling each other niggas and killing this Bloods and Crips stuff. Have to stop, because now, you know, it's about us as a people, as a whole.
It's a human.
Yes.
How are we going to come together and unite as one?
Yes.
Because it's going to happen. The racism is going to increase. You know, they're really going to intensify on blacks against the police, and you know, racism is going to come back into an effect. So we have to be ready as people by staying healthy, staying united as one, and just staying healthy as well.
Yes, exactly. And what do you have to say, Malone? You're just, you know, words. I didn't expect us to give a big rant. You know, we can go on and on about Donald Trump. Hell, we done had more demonic, evil little pink men like him with red eyes, like reptilians.
I kind of feel neither one of them are suitable for the candidacy.
Exactly.
Right. Our freedom, because they all snaky and jakey.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Even our bigger brother, O. We ain't gonna say B, but you know who that is.
Yeah.
They all got that in them, but
yeah.
Overseeing everything, Donald could be the president, but God is in control of the world.
That's right.
The breath we breathe, he's in control of Donald.
And the presidents are just puppets anyway, front men.
And if Donald act crazy, you know how that goes.
Yeah.
He can't act too out of the way, because he's changing already policies already as we speak. He's he's flipping all that slick talk.
Uh-huh.
Ain't nobody going nowhere.
Okay.
You can't afford to. Yeah. He's gonna need all of them in other places.
Well, everybody keep the Spanish people here. And the Spanish people was here anyway with the Indians on the land. The white people need to go. They come from Caucasus Mountains. They talking about sending black people all back to Africa, but black people was all over the doggone world.
Already, right? We was here.
It's like, if
let's talk on that before we go.
We're here. Where you going to go?
Thank you, Isaiah.
We're African Americans.
Kunta Kinte or whoever Shaka Zulu was over there ain't got nothing to do with me over here.
Okay.
At all.
You know, so why they keep talking about send us back, send them back to the mountains where they come from.
Right. Can I say, let's
go ahead, say something.
Sandra B.
Sandra B.
Say what you got to say about their president.
Say what you got to say, Mamacita.
No comment, honey.
No, what was you about
to
say?
No comment.
No comment?
No.
Piche puto Donald Trump. Piche cabrón for the lady. Piche puto Donald Trump. Chupa mi huevos. I'm just playing, y'all. So we got a little bit of time left, Kev. We got a few minutes. So it's almost time to wrap it up, you guys. And the kid, come over here in the thing. Do you see my flyer, Kev? What about got like some Christmas looking stuff on it? Before you be clicking through everything. This my new sister in the you know how the Christians say my new sister in Christ. Well, I'm gonna say my new sister in the business world. Nakia, yes you do. I sent it. That's okay though. This little bossy right here, even though she bigger than me, she a Leo like me, y'all. We that astronomy crap. We bossies. So I want to definitely introduce Nakia. She's the reason why, instead of me worried about rappers and going to the club performing, I was focused on the kids in the hood. You know what I'm saying? And went out there with the kids, right, instead of dealing with rappers. Got me cussing and ranting on my live Facebook. The kids got me that recognition with the city of Los Angeles. So thanks to this queen, I being a hater, you know what I'm saying, and bringing us all together. Mr. Malone, I met him through other people, but we all somehow stayed connected in our own ways. Keep it clean, cut classy, not a ratchet. So, Nakia, let them know real quick. Rebuild your map, rebuild your laugh, and just tell them right quick. We about to get out of here. What we got going on for the Christmas and how they
we
need to get at
us? A toy giveaway. Yeah. We have a toy share giveaway, and if anybody want to donate or feel free to come aboard to donate toys or put a smile on a child, check out the website rebuildyourlaugh.org.
There you go.
And you can contact us on there.
And also, any of you rappers out here with any black cards, you know what I'm saying, if they don't mind y'all spending something in the community, if you can sneak a little something, get at us. I was being funny about that part. Y'all don't probably catch on. You know, they control these industry Negroes' money. They don't let these brothers help with our community. So last but not least, Mike, let these people know what your last words you want to say to the people. If you want to motivate them real quick, like, you know, you the Christ, and you want to tell them don't cry and worry about Donald Trump because there's been more devils that have been running there. If you want to tell the people about where to find you at last, what's coming up, tell them.
You can find us December 22nd at Tiffany's. We'll be doing a hosting live, all the Mike Malone collection models.
Awesome.
With my sister over there headlining.
Yes, Nakia.
Miss Brown.
Model too.
Model slash. My wife will be there. We'll have another guest here. I wish the whole building.
Oh, yeah. Isaiah came through and did the show last weekend, was a host.
Yes.
What? No, that was Melvin. Melvin. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Isaiah. Melvin. Your two Browns here, brothers.
If you want me to, it's
not. Yeah, I forget. Oh, yeah. So we can get Isaiah to come a host.
There it is.
Okay. There you go. See, that's what C. Bossy connected stuff. Yeah, there you go. My bad. There you go.
You can so finish going. Mike Malone. On the Mike Malone Collection, Instagram, MikeBoogie123. Shit, Mike Malone all day. Just see us. We ready to bless all sizes as well. Reach at me, 213-318-7538. And I want to say God is good all the time.
That's right. Amen. Hallelujah. And it's Sunday still. Now, Isaiah, say your last remarks, bro, to whatever you want to say to the people. If there's anything you didn't get to mention, go on ahead and let them know it. Right? Let it be known right now.
I just want to tell my people, just stay healthy, stay blessed. And let's stay united.
Yes.
And God is good.
Amen.
All the time.
Okay. Any last words you want to say, B?
Yeah, I just want to say that, you know, support the kids, you know. Make a difference for the kids because the kids are our future.
Yes.
They deserve a little something, you know, for the holidays, you know.
Yes.
So support the kids and support the event that the kids putting together. Okay. And show some positivity, and positivity will come your way.
That's right.
That's right.
And my last words I want to say is back to staying awake, staying aware, and staying focused. You know, sometimes I even like the tooted and booted. I'm just being honest today. I feel like Isaiah is a Catholic preacher. I ain't even going to give him that title. I feel like the Lord's in the building. I got to confess my sins amongst men. No, real talk, y'all. Let's stop getting so high, so distracted in our low, poor relationships. If you're not with people just building you up, you need to get away from them. While y'all worried about the Donald Trumps and the Hillary Clintons and whatever the outcomes is going to be and has been, in the midst of that, let's stay healthy. You know what I'm saying? And let's stay focused. And let's stop worrying about the presidents. If you go Google all the presidents of the United States, it's a whole bunch of scarier looking presidents than Donald Trump that we done made it through. So y'all just stay positive, stay focused, stay aware, and let's bring some unity. And to all my Crips, my Bloods, all my Hoovers, my SAs, and all my gangs of all nationalities, it's going to be a time and day where we all going to have to come together. And whoever know how to be a doctor or whatever the case may be, whoever got the sticks and whoever got the, you know what I'm saying, we're going to all have to come together like a camping trip. So let's start sticking together, y'all. Let's unite. And we're going to end out with that Fuck Donald Trump One More Last Time video, y'all. Global Streetway, we thank you for tuning in again. Shouts out to RMC. Mr. Morris, we love you. And y'all go check us out on RMC On Air YouTube channel and continue to watch the replays, y'all. Like us on Facebook. We got the Dietary Resolutions on Facebook. Y'all need to go like. Y'all need to go like Mike Malone's Men's Collection and go like Global Street Wave at Screamin' Bossy and Rebuild Your Laugh. Follow our groups. We thank y'all again for tuning in, and we love y'all. And once again, fuck Donald Trump.
Donald Trump.
Oh, she got some to say now. All right. All right, y'all. Yeah.
Fuck Donald
That's
Trump.
Right.
YG and Nipsey Hussle's video got shut down by cops for an anti-Trump song that's called Donald Trump.
I think we got kicked out because we're a group of black people, and like, I guess people, what's going on in America, they're afraid we're gonna say something or do something, but we just really want to watch the rally, and to get kicked out because we're a group of black people is really crazy. It shows you how racist our own school is. We can't even go to our own school.
Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah. I like white folks, but I don't like you. All the niggas in the hood wanna fight you. Surprise, El Chapo ain't tried to snipe you. Surprise, the Nation of Islam ain't tried to find you. Have a rally out LA, we gon' fuck it up. Home of the ride and the King Ride, we don't give a fuck. Black students ejected from your rally. What? I'm ready to go right now. Your racist ass did too much. I'm about to turn Black Panther. Don't let Donald Trump win, that nigga cancer. He too rich, he ain't got the answers. He can't make decisions for this country, he gon' crash us. No, we can't be a slave for him. He got me appreciating Obama way more. Hey, Donald, and everyone that follows, you gave us your reason to be president, but we hate you. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
I don't like your
yeah,
ass.
Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah,
I really
fuck
don't
Donald
like you,
Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah,
That's
fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
Nigga, am I tripping? Let me know. I thought all that Donald Trump bullshit was a joke. Know what they say when rich niggas go broke. Look, Reagan so coke, Obama so hope, Donald Trump spent his trust fund money on the vote. I'm from a place where you probably can't go. Speaking for some people that you probably ain't know. It's pressure built up and it's probably gonna blow. And if we say go, then they probably gonna go. You vote Trump, then you probably on dope. And if you like me, then you probably ain't know. And if you been in jail, you could probably still vote. If we let this nigga win, we gon' probably feel broke. You build walls, we gon' probably dig holes. And if your ass do win, you gon' probably get smoked,
fuck
nigga.
Fuck Donald Trump.
Fuck you.
Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall.
Yeah.
Mark my words.
Yeah.
Hold up, I fuck with Mexicans. Got a plug with Mexicans. When a little need a switch, who I call Mexican. It's Comedy Central, ass nigga, come be the president. Hold up, Nip, tell the world how you fuck with Mexicans.
It wouldn't be the USA without Mexicans. And if it's time to team up, shit, let's begin. Black love, brown pride, and a sense again. White people feel the same as my next kin. Let this nigga win, God bless the kids.
God bless the kids, this nigga wicked and weird. When me and Nip link, that's Bloods and Crips. When your LA rally, we gon' crash your shit. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.